What's going on, everyone? It's me, Bernie, from Everything Dogs. And after a long Christmas break, we are back again with a new video. I hope you guys had a good holiday season and are all set for a good 2021. Today's video is an important one and is about one of the deadliest diseases that can affect both dogs and humans, rabies. I'm going to talk about the disease itself and how dangerous it can be, along with some signs to identify rabies in dogs, along with some steps that we can take to protect our dogs and ourselves from this killer disease. Before getting into the video, I wanted to thank you all for subscribing to the channel. We have officially touched 500 subscribers on YouTube. Your support means a lot to us. So please continue watching our content. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please head over and click that red subscribe button and the bell icon so you can get notified when we upload new content. Please also make sure to follow our Instagram, where we post fun content about our dogs almost every day. As always, let's get some basics out of the way first. Rabies is a vaccine-preventable, zoonotic, viral disease and is caused by a group of viruses called Lyssa viruses. Once the symptoms appear, it is 100% fatal. 99% of human infections are through dogs. And India has the highest rate of human rabies in the world, with an estimated yearly death toll of about 20,000, accounting for 30% of all rabies-related deaths worldwide. Humans can contract rabies when they are bitten or scratched by an infected animal. Saliva from an infected animal can transmit rabies if it comes into contact with an open wound, eyes, mouth, or nose. Symptoms in human beings can include partial paralysis, anxiety, insomnia, confusion, agitation, abnormal behavior, paranoia, terror, and fear of water. Survival is almost unknown once symptoms have presented, even with intensive care. And death usually occurs 2 to 10 days after first symptoms. It is a scary disease and a terrible way to go. In dogs, the amount of time from infection to showing signs of rabies can vary from a few days to 6 months or even more. Once the disease enters the body, it travels by the nerves until it reaches the central nervous system. From there, it spreads to the salivary glands, where it prepares to spread to another victim. There is unfortunately no cure for rabies in dogs, and it is almost always fatal. Once clinical symptoms occur, an infected animal usually dies within 5 days. The only way to test for rabies is by examination of the brain tissue of the dead animal. So yeah, it's a pretty deadly disease. But there are some ways to identify a rabid dog through the symptoms he or she displays. It's not always easy. There is some merit in learning how to identify the early signs. Essentially, there are 3 stages of the onset of rabies, and I'll walk you through the symptoms of each stage. Number 1 is the early stage, which can last between 2 to 10 days. During this time, the dog will seem sick with general symptoms. These include muscle pain, restlessness, irritability, or a general feeling of sickness and discomfort. If you notice these symptoms, search the dog for any bite mark or signs of a recent fight. If you find a bite mark or wound of any kind, you must take your dog to the vet immediately for evaluation. Number 2 is the mild rabies stage, and this lasts between 3 to 7 days. This stage is also called as paralytic rabies because your dog may foam around the mouth and get paralyzed. He or she might also seem confused and their lower jaw may drop. This also causes them to make a strange barking sound that doesn't sound like a normal bark. You may also notice that they have difficulty in swallowing. In this form of rabies, dogs are not necessarily vicious and rarely try to bite. Number 3 is the aggressive form of rabies, and this also lasts about 3 to 7 days. This is the more typical form of rabies and what people generally think of when they think of rabies. This creates excessive aggression and must be handled with extreme caution to prevent being bitten. Symptoms of this form of rabies include hydrophobia, which is a fear of water. Dogs will not go near water and will seem uneasy or panic at the sound or touch of water. You will notice increased aggression, and dogs may viciously show all their teeth. Restlessness and discomfort can also be seen in this form. The slightest provocation may cause the dog to attack and bite. The dog might even do this without any provocation at all. Other abnormal behavior you may notice would be chewing on rocks or even their own legs. So if you see a dog displaying any of these symptoms while you are on a walk with your dog, I would advise caution. If your dog has been bitten by other dogs with such symptoms, bring them to a vet as soon as possible. The rabies virus can live on a dog's fur for up to 2 hours, so you may want to wear gloves while handling the dog. While recovery of your dog is something your vet will need to evaluate carefully, you must take precautions to protect yourself as you are equally vulnerable to the disease. Well, that pretty much wraps up what I wanted to share on this subject. Rabies is serious, and as responsible pet parents, it is important that we take the steps needed to protect our dogs and ourselves from this virus. Regular rabies vaccination is non-negotiable for your dogs. Keeping an eye out for dogs in your neighborhood that are showing symptoms that we just talked about can go a long way in protecting both people and dogs from rabies. I hope you guys found this video helpful, and if you did, please be sure to smash that like button. Share this video with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one.